I'm sorry, I have to do a second part to my introduction. There's a couple of important things I'd like to mention, maybe a few more, but I'd like you to know too that Metro Transit, okay, refuses to provide safe transportation for wheelchairs where they're tie-down straps. So usually the anchors that are anchored to the floor, the mechanisms are bent, and then often they come unhooked and the chairs become loose. Some of the ratchets, the straps let go completely and the chair slides across the floor. There's many, many other things. I've asked Metro Transit to make the tie-down systems on the buses safe and use the updated system that uses actual hooks. And Metro Transit comes up with excuses they can't afford to, or they won't. And I said, what, you're willing to endanger my life and other people's lives to travel on public transit because you can't afford to spend a couple hundred dollars per bus to put the safe seatbelt straps or cargo straps in there, and they won't fix it. Anyway, look, there's many other issues about the way the wheelchairs are being secured or not secured on buses. But the reason why I decided to do this little sequel here, this little second part, is that I forgot to mention in my first clip, is that as a result of my incident with Metro Transit and the bus terminal and them not allowing me to get off the bus, after all this was over, at the end, Metro Transit has banned me from all properties that belong to Metro Transit. They won't let me use the buses, the ferries, or anything else. And on this day, it happened to be a rainy day, and they left me in a pretty bad situation where I was told I couldn't take a bus to get back home. And so I pleaded with people at the bus terminal. I went back and I pleaded with them to see if they cared how bad people in wheelchairs are being treated. And I was just amazed at the little response that I got from the public that was there. So I'm just hoping that these videos here will help people to realize that people that are disabled need your help. And, I hope and pray that you don't become disabled one day. And if you do, you'll hope and pray that somebody will help you when you have these huge difficulties with the government. I know we've all got our difficulties in our life, but we live together and we've got to help each other. And by the way, I want to mention too that my grievance on this bus had nothing to do with the driver. The driver was actually a very good human being, and it's a shame that he had to go through this. And the few other passengers that were on the bus, I apologize to them too, but I had no choice. I did not want to go to Halifax, and the bus driver was told that he wasn't allowed to let me off the bus. So anyway, thank you for watching these videos, and hopefully you'll get some inspiration from all of this, and maybe other people who are disabled will come forward and get their voice heard, because I've been fighting for everybody now to get our voice heard. So please help. Thank you. Bye.